going out on a service call here.
Not a service call. Going out on a route.
The one story that always stands out to me from our customers are the stories of people that talk about how a CSA share in their family has brought them back to the table.
Funny, the name Second Nature has double meanings in that, you know, it's always been second nature. We've had this kind of gift to be able to pick a product that people like.
So. It's important for our community to know that 90% of the seeds that we had available to us when we came to this country are now extinct.
We reach for minimal packaging just because of my personal ideals. I prefer less waste.
Our community really came through, and that's the only reason we're here.
Today we're at the Flower Basket, which is at 520 East Terhune Street in Viroqua. We're about four blocks off of Main Street. I'm Jess Krieger, and I am employed here at the Flower Basket as the operations manager. So I spend time with the employees, doing bookkeeping, working with our vendors, basically making sure the shop is running well.
My name is Arwen Wildingway, and I live here in Viroqua. I am the greenhouse manager. So this place is very historic for Viroqua. Back a ways before anyone can remember, the Frohawks built these greenhouses before the 40s. They also had an orchard out back, and they sold fruits and vegetables here from back before the 40s. From 1949 to 1975, Manny Fry owned this greenhouse and he expanded it. We started with just one greenhouse and a little flower shop that's actually on the next door property. And now he built two more greenhouses, and then he built another greenhouse. So that made four greenhouses. And in 75, he sold it to two employees. They were Jim Olson and Jim Smith. They worked together for several years, and then in 89, they were done with it. It was just vacant for a while, and then Al Peterson came and bought the place and revived it. And he and his wife Kim have been operating it until just last year. I started working with them a couple years ago. I knew they wanted to retire, so I started like apprenticing with them. I got paid a little bit, but mainly I was just hanging out here, like observing, seeing how to run the place and everything. And started trying to understand how to take over such a big business. Not just one person really, you know, could do it, because it's so many plants to water, to maintain, to, you know, plus all the customer service. It's just, you know, a lot of human power to keep the place going. So wanting to have a lot of people working together, because it's such a good opportunity.
Right now we have myself and Arwen, who are working together as, you know, co-managers. And then we have a facilities person. His name is Joshua. He comes in a few days a week and helps with the upkeep of the greenhouses, replacing the plastic. You know, he's kind of maintenance in a sense. Also making soil, which is a big job that we have here.
We mix soil, all our own. Everything.
Yeah, all the soil's mixed.
It's heavy.
It's very heavy.
Yeah.
Which is unique, because a lot of greenhouses, of course, just have blends brought in, custom blends brought in, shipped from somewhere else. So we're taking all the raw materials and making our own soil, which we think is pretty unique and makes a really high quality product, you know, in the end, our plants. And then we also have a florist. Her name is Morgan. And so she runs the shop. So she does the day-to-day daily arrangements. We get calls for things like birthdays, funerals, of course, the big holidays like Valentine's Day and Mother's Day, but it's a lot of just day-to-day occasions that people are calling, and that can be fresh floral arrangements, that can also be houseplants that we then put together in combination planters and things. And then also things like weddings, you know, in the spring and summer, where we're putting out bigger bouquet, making bouquets and boutonnieres, corsages, things like that. And then we have seasonal employees that will work for a short period of time in the spring and help with all the greenhouse work that needs to be done, and then perhaps also doing customer service and retail work later in the spring. So the year that Pleasant Ridge Waldorf School purchased the flower basket, would have been August, I believe it was August 10th of 2015.
Pleasant Ridge had been looking for a social enterprise, a business to help keep the tuition low. So Pleasant Ridge decided to, you know, dive in and get the 3.5 acres of property to be able to use for, we've been having our school garden here for about 9 years now. So this could be a, you know, property to have activities on. We'll probably have some summer camps starting this summer, as well as being profitable enough to help with the school. 9 years ago, we started a school garden here. I was a market gardener in Pennsylvania for 13 years. And so to move to town was like, you know, a lot to, you know, like I just had to keep. So like, oh, this school doesn't have a garden. I'll start the school garden here. And Al and Kim were happy. Al was like, oh, it's less I have to mow, you know? So we started, you know, planting garlic there. Planting greens for the lunches was mainly what works best. We, you know, some potatoes, some herbs, some tomatoes, peppers, things like that. So we've been doing that, working with the kids there. And then this year, after we got this property, we, at the same time, totally coincidentally, this woman who's a professional garden education coordinator is in town now too. So Erica Pfeiffer Hill is awesome. She helps with the teachers in the classes, comes up with, you know, activities for the classes to come and do here. So this will be the first full year of having her. So that's really an awesome step. Well, third grade always has a gardening block. They're all third grade, you know, so we plant garlic that year, and they go to different farms and visit animals and, you know, really get a sense of food, like how to produce food. And well, they also do textile that year and home, they building it, carpentry, they do that year as well. And then we're expanding it. First grade grew some microgreens, little tiny greens, for this winter hot lunch. We have started a worm farm. We built some hot compost piles, so the kids got an understanding of the layering of the different kinds of things that you need to make the compost hot and active. We did that this fall.
Well, I think, you know, in general, I think the idea is that this will just keep increasing the connection with the school. You know, there's thoughts this summer, there's probably going to be at least a couple of different summer camps that are going to be homed here, to utilize the land and the space. So I think it makes sense. You know, the school is just a block away, and this is this big 3.5 acre property that's beautiful and a lot of open space, which is important to Waldorf education, to have room for children to learn and play and use their bodies, learn how to make compost, see plants growing, be involved with the garden. It's such a big part of the curriculum. So to me, it feels like a natural fit that we would have something beyond just the school building that's, you know, that the kids can then be over here exploring the natural world in such a, you know, big setting. So I feel like those opportunities are just going to keep increasing as time goes on. And then also hearing from the larger community what, you know, I think the vision is that it won't necessarily, you know, we're starting with Pleasant Ridge because they own it, so the children there that are, you know, are going to utilize it probably first, but a lot of these programs hopefully will expand to include the wider community, you know, but it just takes time.
And also already Youth Initiative has been helping. They've been giving service hours, coming over here and helping. It's been super great having young bodies that are strong, and you know they're learning a lot too. Also, Thoreau College is starting up, so our garden's going to be really nice this summer. Lots of good help.
Certainly a highly seasonal business. It ebbs and flows depending on the time of year. Clearly spring is our busiest season. April and May and June, we're having the garden shop outside, selling annuals and perennials. And then we also have Mother's Day, which is a big cut flower holiday. And then there's a lot of maintenance that happens throughout the summer after the spring season winds down. That's the time to come back into the greenhouse and kind of do some of the repairs and things that maybe didn't happen. And as we move into fall, then outside we're having mums and people are still out, you know, shopping and planting bulbs.
And perennials,
still. You know. And then over the holidays, you know, Thanksgiving into Christmas, we grow poinsettias right here. We start them from tiny little babies. We're really proud of our homegrown. A lot of our plants are homegrown, where we're starting them from either seed or very small cuttings, which is unlike, say, plants that are at other places that are maybe shipped in from somewhere else. We're really cultivating and nourishing and growing them here. Which we, really to us feels something unique that we offer the community. So poinsettias and wreaths, you know, the garlands and things during Christmas time. And then another big floral holiday, of course, is into Valentine's Day. So as you can see, we really just follow the seasons and what we're offering and what we're growing. And there's always something happening. And we're also always looking ahead, because a lot of it we're finding is, you know, 6 months, 9 months, a year out, you know, we're preparing for that next big season, even though it feels like it's, you know, 6 months away or more. Especially because we are growing a lot of our own plants, we have to think ahead. It's not just ordering something 2 weeks before Christmas. We're already planning for Christmas.
So my background is I went to college for I wanted to study solar engineering, but they didn't have that at the school I went to, so I did mechanical engineering. And I also got a expressive arts degree, so I had kind of both sides of my brain balanced. Then after that, I did some carpentry. And then I became a market gardener. So in Pennsylvania, in State College, where Penn State is, I had a went to farmer's market for 13 years there. And then due to my stepkids' situation, we moved here closer to their mom. And so here there were already farmers. I didn't have to be a farmer anymore and sell organic produce. So I hooked in with the co-op, the Viroqua Food Co-op, and organic produce, organic farmers, all over connections. Really nice. Here they have a master gardener program that I jumped into as soon as I could. So I've been practicing my master gardening, getting my hours in every year for the past, I think it's been 10 years now. So that's been a nice way to, you know, connect with the community. The Driftless Area Garden Club as well. I've been a president there for a few years, active member for as long as it's been here. So another, again, like 10 years or something. We do different classes. We meet every second Monday of the month. If anyone is connected, would like to join other plant heads. I call myself a plant head, you know. That's what I think about a lot is plants. I think that's mainly it. Right? Yeah.
Great.
And now I'm here. Now I'm surrounded.
Let's see. So my background is pretty varied, which I think was partially why I ended up here at the Flower Basket. I have a degree in sociology, so I worked in social work and in education for some years. And I'm always fascinated by groups of people and how they work together and how we can work better together as people. And making connections, networking, that's a strong
place that I have a lot of interest in is networking, making connections, and seeing projects starting and keeping them going over the long term. And then I had children and was a stay-at-home mother for quite some years, but I always had interest in plants and gardening and herbs, and I taught classes. And then for the last few years, I was, and even years before I had kids, have worked at different organic farms. So it was kind of a natural combination of things coming together for me, working here at the Flower Basket, my interest in people and systems and how things work, and then also an interest in plants and growing and children and education, and it kind of all came together in this job, which I felt was really well suited for my kind of diverse background that I've had. So I'm very happy to be here.
Al and Kim have been super helpful. They want this to succeed, so they have been, you know, offering their services to fill in when we need someone to consult with. I can call them anytime and ask them a question or text them. They come in and help. So it's really maintaining a nice consistency and a quality. You know, we want to have high quality products for people. And so there's always a learning process. And so being able to tap into people who know, you know, flowers. I don't know flowers as well as vegetables, so they're really helping. We do have the same products, the same plants as what they've carried in the past. We have so many colors of petunias, verbenas, million bells, all kinds of things, you know, that you've gotten here in the past. We have them as well as more things. Like, we have a few more different kinds of herbs this year. A few more kinds of flowers, perennials. We're going to have some really awesome perennial selection this year.
Well, one of the services that the Petersons offered that the community really appreciated was these combination planters or baskets, where you would bring your, you know, beautiful outdoor planter that you had, and then we'll fill it with soil and then work with different colors and combinations of plants. Maybe the customer has an idea, or maybe they just will give us free license and trust that we'll make something beautiful for them. And the nice thing is if you can start that early, like in April, it gets all this nice warmth and humidity in the greenhouse. So by the time you pick it up in May, you've got this lush, beautiful, uniquely your own combination planter or planters for your home or your business. And, you know, we did all the work for you. And it, you know, it wasn't something that you had to spend your whole Saturday putting together or trying to figure out which colors went, or, ooh, is this plant good for shade or sun, or can I put these together? We've done all that. And then you just pick up the finished product. So we're going to continue to offer that, because we definitely have heard from customers that that is something they really appreciated the Petersons doing. And we're getting, as Arwen said, Kim and Al are still really involved with helping us make sure that, you know, they're going to come in and help with those types of things to guide us, to give us mentorship, to continue doing that, to help us for those things. So our customers, well, we've found that a lot of our, the Petersons customers continue to come to the Flower Basket. A lot of the connections that they built over the years, especially with local churches and organizations that really count on good quality plants for their businesses, have continued to patronize the Flower Basket. I feel like we're still getting known to the community, that we're still here. You know, sometimes we'll get questions, you know, are you still offering? I think anytime there's a changeover in even a business that's been here running as a greenhouse for
75
years, people are still wondering, you know, they heard that Pleasant Ridge bought the school, so maybe they are thinking it's just for education. So I think part of what these first few years is going to be about is reassuring the community that we're still here, we're still offering high quality plants and customer service, just as the Petersons did, and more. So, but I think it's going to take, you know, it takes time when things have, you know, new ownership.
And we have this awesome greenhouses with the nice heated beds that go all winter. Most of the other greenhouses in the area start up in the spring, so they don't have the length of time for some products. And us being able to take, you know, have our own things go from year to year is different. So something that you've had one year where you know is the same the next year. Yeah, we're right in town. That's, you know, you can come here and see everything. You know, beforehand, you can come and claim a basket that you like before you take it home. We can put your name on it for you. You can come and look at, you know, the different kinds of flowers, different kind of annuals we have, and just start ruminating in your mind, you know, before you're ready to actually plant. Just start thinking, oh, I think I might have white over here, and I'm going to put some pink over there, you know, so like just start planning for yourself. Also, we have this nice space where we're sitting right now where you can come and have like a little meeting on a cloudy day or a cold day in the winter, be surrounded by plants. We're happy to have you come and share your carbon dioxide with our little friends and, you know, just have like a little mini vacation for yourself over here.
Another unique thing I think we offer is that we have in our floral shop, garden shop, you know, year round, we bring in, sweet little things for your home, or things for your garden, whether that's, really nice handmade concrete monuments for your garden at home, or perhaps for a gravestone, things like that. We also offer silk flower arrangements, so we can have our florist, you know, if cut flowers doesn't work for you, or you want something that's going to have longevity, you know, in a certain place, our florists can make something really beautiful for a space, whether that's at a home or a business.
Or a cemetery.
Mm-hmm.
We do memorial urns every spring.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good bit of our business, actually, is because we're so close to the cemetery that, you know, and that's really a way to honor our ancestors, is to, you know, go and visit where they are now, you know, where their bodies are now, and to just remind them that we love them. So people really share their love in a cemetery with, say, the geraniums or planting, or with a saddle, you know, for on top of the gravestone, or just different little gifts there. Mm-hmm.
Right now we're in the floral shop, and I am making a bouquet. We had an order this morning. We get orders in through the phone. Local people call. We also get calls from family members from all over the country calling that know the flower basket and want us to deliver. And then we also get internet orders through a service called Teleflora, which that helps host our website. And then the orders come right through, and they come right through our printer. So the day can really vary from lots and lots of orders to a slower day. It might just be a few, a little trickle in. And of course, we also get walk-in customers who like to come and look at our cooler over here. We can go look over there. So this is our floral cooler. And we try to have, ideally, we have some arrangements already made that folks can just come right in and grab something. And then, so every week we, our floral delivery comes from Krieger Wholesale, which is out of Marshfield, which is near Stevens Point. And they come once a week, and we get to pick flowers off of the truck. So then we refresh our cooler and pick out new things. And then, of course, we also grow things like tulips and bulbs, the paper whites and the little irises and things. So we try to have blooming plants as well. And then in our shop out here, we've got, of course, course, this year we're having seeds. We have direct seeds from a company called Cornucopia. And then we have house plants, and we try to have just a nice display out here of different house plants that folks can come in and buy. And then other things like these concrete plaques and things that folks can put in their gardens or at grave sites. And then also things like these statues, like this angel here. I try to always have a few of those in stock. People like those for their gardens to add interest beyond just, you know, their flowers. And then we sell soil too. We sell the soil that we use. We have an organic potting soil that we sell, and then we have a fortified potting soil, which is great for your annuals and perennials. And then we also sell we'll have a bigger selection, you know, seasonally in the spring, you know, when we're outside in the garden shop. But things like insecticidal soaps and repellents, and then also fertilizers and things for your gardens and your hanging baskets and things. And we always have a great selection of houseplants. A lot we grow our own, and then some that we've got a customer coming in here. Yeah, and then we can just peek in here real quick. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Just fine.
Good. So this is our sitting room. So if you were interested in having your wedding flowers done with us, whether that was fresh flowers or silk flowers, this is where we would sit. You'd sit with our florist and talk that all out. This is where we keep all our baskets. We are the flower basket after all. And we use these baskets quite a bit for arrangements and for houseplants. And then our silk flowers. We have a selection of silk flowers that folks can help to get color ideas. Of course, we can always order special things too if you've got a certain favorite color or plant you want. You know, we have access to that. We don't always have we don't have everything that we could get. Hi, welcome to the greenhouse.
Let's see, the first thing probably most people notice are our geraniums. We are famous for our geraniums. We grow thousands and thousands. We have had the cemetery contract for the past several years, and we grow 6,300 geraniums for them every year. So that takes up a lot of our space. This is the beginnings of them. We will fill more than this. You know, this is only 1,000 right here. So, yeah. So that's one of our big projects that we are honored and happy to be doing. We also have nice little succulent gardens. Well, let's see. This is we call it a succulent bench. We've got different cactuses, things that like light but not water. So you don't have to water the things on this bench very much at all, but do put them in a sunny window if you have it. And then different places in our greenhouse are a little more shady, so we try to, you know, match the plants to the requirements. So like begonias, they don't really need too much bright sun, you know, direct sun, so we have them these more over in the shady part. And then over here is, we call it our foliage bench, and this is like our houseplant bench. So we've got everything from ferns that like an east or a west window and a lot of moisture, so you keep them like on a pebble tray, so a lot of humidity, maybe have it in your bathroom or your kitchen sink, so ferns. So we have plants that like shady things, different colored plants that don't need much care, like this Fittonia. You know, look at those leaves. I mean, those leaves have pink and green. You don't even have to wait for a flower. You can have pink without a flower. Plants that help clean your air. So like these spider plants or airplane plants, they're called. They are on the list of plants that really help clean your air and make your inside atmosphere more healthy for people. Take the toxins out of the air. What else is along here? We've got different like flowing plants that drape down. You can put this like on a shelf and then have it be draping down. It's a nice effect. We've got different smelling plants. This is one of my favorites. This is scented geranium that smells like lemon lime soda pop. I call this a 7-Up plant. Here, smell this. What else? Geraniums actually can make a nice house plant. This has been here all winter, and look, it's happily showing itself to you right now. What else? So that's what this bench is. And then this is greenhouse three. All winter we just have two greenhouses, and then we start expanding into other greenhouses. Now we're in both three and four. We have perennials coming on. We're potting up our perennials today. We've already started our baskets for people. We've got combination baskets. We also have all solid baskets of petunias, million bells, verbenas. So we start things early, and to get them nice and thick and not be straggly, we have to trim them often. So that's another one of our jobs that's, you know, starting, is going through and trimming everything to make it just bush out and be full and ready for your gardens. So this is our greenhouse number four. We've got things that are like a cooler in here right now. The rosemary's gonna go out soon. Our parsley I harvested. So in here is the potting room. We have our starting mix here, and we actually do buy that one. And then we mix actual soil, topsoil, with peat moss and perlite, and that's our general soil that we use for most things. You know, the hanging baskets get a mix of the combination. The roses need a different kind of a soil, so we make a different kind of soil for that. We also make another sand soil. The succulents need a different kind of a soil, so it's, you know, a little bit of this and that. We start putting stuff outside usually the beginning of May, but we do have some, you know, people can come in before that. Like, we don't put stuff out until we're really sure that everything is going to be okay out there. That doesn't mean we don't have it, though. Like, some people will come by and be like, oh, they don't have anything, you know, because it's not outside yet. But please feel free to come in and look. You know, pansies will be one of the first things out. Pansies can go up probably today. It's so warm. You know, so we have things for all the seasons, the cold to the warm and then to the cold again. What do we love the most, the very most? I like that every day is different. Watching things grow, like, you know, the planting the seed, and then it's up, and then, you know, the next week it's this taller, and then in a couple of weeks it has flowers. So, like, just the amount of change that happens here is just very stimulating. And to me, it doesn't really feel like work. Like, I'm using my body a lot, and I'm carrying and lifting, and, you know, but it's fun. You know, it's like I'm making change. I'm making things better. You know, is how it feels to me. So, you know, I'm helping people get more beauty in their lives. So that's really valuable to me.
See, I think probably the thing that I love the most about being here at the Flower Basket, almost always when someone either walks into the greenhouse or I deliver flowers to them, regardless of the occasion, it makes people happy. They breathe deep when they walk into the greenhouse. They, oh, you know, I mean, you can just sense this emotion. I think it really, plants and flowers help us feel. And I think that that's important for us to be feeling. We are human beings. And so I appreciate that I get to witness that. And it's sometimes it's sadness, it's for a funeral or somebody, you know, there's a loss. Or sometimes it's a wedding and a celebration and there's lots of happiness and joy. But regardless, it's just there's a lot more feeling involved than I ever thought in this job. And I just appreciate, like I said, I appreciate that I get to witness that and be part of that in some way. And just be part of people's lives that way.
Well, I would certainly say one of the biggest challenges is, like we mentioned before, just the seasonality of working with plants and live plants, is that, you know, you cut flowers come in and maybe they don't look as, you know, good as they could or something. You know, I mean, there's just, when you're working with things that have a life cycle, you know, that challenge is that you need to be on top of things, you know, and you need to, and that's at times perhaps could be, I don't want to say stressful because it's not really stressful, but it's not controllable. So there's a surrender. Oh, I know I have to do this now. No way around it. So got to be on your toes when you're working with plants and live, you know, flowers coming in and things, which is exciting, but also keeps you on your toes.
Right. Finding what's the priority that day is definitely the skill. yeah. And, you know, challenges, I think, you know, you alluded to other greenhouses or other places in the area. I think, you know, there's probably more in the now than there have been in the past. So there's a little more competition. So that's, you know, challenging, you know, to keep our market share, you know, and everything. So, you know, keeping our costs down, reminding ourselves always to do that so that, you know, we can keep in business and everything.
And one place that we have needed help at is with marketing and social media. It's just not something that Arwen and I have had a lot of practice in. We're getting better, but, you know, there's some folks that can just, and we think our new florist can just plug right into that.
My dream is to have like a kitchen, a certified, you know, kitchen, so that we can expand our winter greens growing. I'd also like to transition to organic and be able to spend the money to bring in more beneficial insects as our insect control. That would be nice, and just more food, like more even outside food to have out there to be able to share with the community. Also, I'd love to see some nice, like, paths through our land that has, you know, different gardens, different kind of specialized gardens, so that people can take a walk and have a, like, a botanical garden kind of a thing, different varieties and things. Mm-hmm. Also, we're thinking of having a cutting garden, so being able to cut a bunch of our own flowers this year, you know, to sell through the shop. So hopefully that'll manifest this year.
Let's see. Boy, this is going to be tough. Oh, I know what my favorite plant certainly is. I would say Arwen's homegrown dahlias that she brings in from her garden that we sell in the floral shop in season. They are just fantastic.
And what's the season?
Those are usually what, August and September?
Yeah.
Dahlias. They're a huge, big, huge flower. Lots of great color. They're just, that's what popped in my mind.
That's nice.
My favorite plant.
Yeah, I have a beautiful dahlia collection. And we'll be selling some here in pots, so we'll have a nice dahlia collection this year.
You got one?
Okay, well, I'll say rosemary. Because I named my daughter Rosemary. Rosemary. And it just smells so good and makes you feel awake. I guess that would be it. And it's evergreen. An evergreen plant. So, right?
Yeah. I didn't know that.
This business is also about being artistic with live things. Mm-hmm. Like, so you are creating your yard, you know, it's an expression of yourself. So have fun with that, you know, do what makes you happy, you know, with plants. Show your favorite thing. Show off you know, what makes you happy right there in your yard, you know. Mm-hmm. It's a good opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Our phone number is 608-637-8200. So our website through Teleflora, which is where people would order, you know, bouquets for, you know, arrangements and things like that, that's flowersviroqua.com. We also have another website which talks more about the connection with Pleasant Ridge Waldorf School, who owns the flower basket. And that website is?
And it has all the plants, it has the listing of the plants and our prices of the plants on prwsflowerbasket.org is that one.
So we have two websites.
I guess I would just like to say else about how proud we are that we are continuing a historic business in a historic facility. So we're keeping a tradition alive. It's been amazingly heartwarming to feel the support from the community. Everyone's been so excited that we're doing this, and it feels really good. I feel like we are going to be successful because so many people are lending their support in lots of different ways. So thank you for that.